the super city.
Watch out, Banksy. I was mayor of your hometown. Now I might be mayor of the current city you're mayor of.
We'll be right after break. Thanks for your call, Richard. 0800 723 465 is our number.
Bit of a scoop.
You love that, don't you, mate?
So when did you go after that? What did you go after that, George? What happened after, like, after you, when you, once you got to school?
Oh, and when I, I left after school certificate. I left school and I left home. I wanted to...
So you would have had to escape the whole small town conundrum and go somewhere where no one knew.
We're living in Papeto in Auckland. I finished college.
So you, but it's still a suburb, isn't it? So you've got to leave there. Everyone knows you.
Let's just say, between Papatoa and Manurewa was the Wurri pub, nothing else.
Yep. So how old were you when you moved out of home and
I turned 17 when I'd started to transition, and in the intervening time, I'd 18 months or so.
Did you have a mentor or someone that took you under their wing?
Yes. I'll talk about how that, you know, because I went down for one purpose, but then something, a revelation happened to me. I could be who I was because I suddenly saw it before me at Carmen's.
When you were a child, though, were you like, you must have got that sense that you were sitting on an island all by yourself and, you know, like there must have been a lot of confusion and...
Absolutely, but what could you do about it? And I just conformed. It was the easiest way.
Question, do you think that kids today could handle what you went through?
The world was a different place then than it is now.
It was worse then. I mean, it's actually acceptable now, but...
up to a point.
Well, you know, you left school at 16. You left home at 16. I left home at 16. My balls hadn't even dropped when I left home. What age did you leave home?
Yeah, 17.
Yeah, see, whereas kids today, they hang into like...
Well, it's too easy at home. I mean, I kind of joke. I started having a family late, but mates who've got kids that are in their late teens, early 20s, we'll joke that it's the parents that move out these days, not the kids, because life's too comfortable at home.
I don't know if it's too comfortable. I just think that as parents, we feel that our kids, can't handle it.
But no, absolutely lonely. Of course, the irony is that if it had been a subject you could bring out, there were others who are just like you. But you feel like a, you know, and
that's much like the narcissist.
And if there's no one you can go to talk about, no one. You can't talk about it with anyone, or you couldn't then.
Well, it's much like the narcissist. Once you admit, and then you'll suddenly see a whole lot of other heads pop up. But you could recognise others like you, couldn't you?
Yes.
You walk into a room and you recognise. I recognise nutters everywhere. You know, even nutters who haven't recognised that they're nutters yet. I can see it. You can just see it. You walk in and you go, ha ha, ha ha. You're one of us. You haven't acknowledged yet, and you must do the same thing. You must even today. You
spot them at 50 paces. You know,
well, even young kids. You must notice it in young kids as well.
Yes, I do, because I've had parents and grandparents and caregivers who bring young children and people who they think are either transgender or they think they're transgender or gay.
We're on. Oh, welcome back to the show, where our very special guest with me and David Kodire is Georgina Byer. Georgina, so